Hi lovelies, it's me Sherry with Live Love Latte, and thanks for joining me for this Day in the Life video. I'm here in my master closet, and recently I picked up the book, The Life-Changing Magic of Tidying Up by Marie Kondo. The reason I picked up the book is because my favorite blogger, Tony, from A Bowl Full of Lemons, Instagram a picture of the book, and I thought, you know what, if she's reading it, it's probably worth the read. So I started the book last Thursday, and a few chapters in, I was thinking, you know, this sounds kind of like already books I've read or things that I already do. And then the next day, I watched this video from Living Like Julie. I'm going to put the link below to that video. And she was implementing the KonMari method on her clothing. And as I watched that video, it started making more sense to me. It started sinking in. And so I really went to go read the book with a more open mind. There are a couple things just with the clothing that has really influenced me, and I'm really thankful for that. And of course, one of them is, if you're reading her book, is to look at your stuff and to think, does this spark joy? So I normally purge my closet twice a year with the change of seasons. So the change of seasons here are hot and not so hot. So I live in the desert, so you know, but for me, 50 degrees is cold already. So that's how we've acclimated. So I normally bring out everything out of my closet. So when I take it out and I do that, I go through each piece of clothing. So that wasn't anything new. But what was new was to really look at it. Does it spark joy? And not, is it something that I want to get rid of or purge, but is it something that I want to keep? So there's a little difference in that. And I think it made all the difference, because when I looked at it and I, you know, there's a couple pieces of clothing that I was stuck on. And when I looked at it and I thought, does this spark joy? It did, but it doesn't now. And so that is what really made me say, you know what, this needs to go into the donate pile. So in this master closet, I have all my clothing, my undergarments, socks, but my shoes, my jewelry, jackets, they are in separate places. So, and they're all in one place. So that's normally what I do anyway, because she does talk about bring every piece of clothing in and don't have it in different parts of the house. So she says to arrange it from heavy, dark to light so that it looks like it's flying away. And so at first I thought, okay, you know, I didn't really take that. It wasn't an aha moment as soon as I read that paragraph, right? But I said, you know what? I went into reading this book. I'm going to really try to apply it. So I did. So I saw that all my clothing is actually opposite of what she says. It goes from light on the far left, dark on the far right, with the rainbow colors in between. And I go from tank tops to sweaters to pants. So the complete opposite. So I tried it on one rack of clothes that I had already finished. And I said, you know what, I'm going to put it the other way. And you know what, it really made a difference. So I started this like on Sunday night for 4 hours. So this is 4 hours in. It's already Thursday. And I really need to get this done, because the mess in my room is driving me crazy. So I'm going to show you that mess. And I didn't film in the beginning or the before, because I just started. I got into it. Then I remembered, oh, I should probably maybe film this. So this is what I have for now. So I usually keep my dresses here, the long ones to the shorter ones. And so you can even see here, it goes from light to dark. So I'll be changing that. These are already the ones that I'm keeping. That's Alpha that I have my undergarments in. And then this was for handbags, but I decided to use it for the pajamas that I put on at night. I do need new loungewear, because all I'm using is tossed off t-shirts and pants, and I need to get nicer loungewear. So I'll probably get two, and I've listed the stuff that I know I need to get or want to get. And then here are the sweaters, and so you could see I did short sleeves to long sleeve, light to dark, so I'll be changing that. Okay, and then these are where my scarves are. I need to go through my scarves. Up here are my swimwear, I think. Yeah. Yeah, so those are my swimwear. And then the, what is here? Oh, and then my clutch handbag. So obviously I'm not done, because I haven't labeled those. And so I have all this space here. I even took down all the luggage and I rearranged those and made sure that I only kept the things that I need to keep in there, like the travel pillows and the toiletries bags. That's Cicely's bag. This is my husband's side of the closet. I'm not going to show that to you now. It's organized for him, but we haven't applied the KonMari method on that, and we'll do that later. But you can see even here how I went from light to dark with his jackets. And then here are the my Lulu tops and tank tops, and then, you know, then my pants and my skirts. And look, guys, I only have two pairs of jeans. I actually only have five. I got rid of three. These are just some of the stuff that has been, that came out of our closet. This is my donate pile. I don't know if you can see that. See, that's my donate, that came from my closet. And I really thought I was only keeping the things in my closet that I was going to keep, but really, they don't spark joy. So these are some, let me show you. These are some of the shirts that I had trouble with, because I'm like, you know what, I like them, they're so pretty, I had so many compliments, but you know what, they serve their purpose, and I'm thankful that they serve their purpose, that at that time I got those compliments, and that I felt good in the shirt, and I feel like I look good in it, but no more, right? This pile is my are my winter clothes, so I need to probably go a second time through that, because even now that I've had a few days off, I look at it and I'm like, you know what, there's a, probably a few things there that I can still let go of because they don't spark joy. And then here are some more the handbags that I need to go through. Okay, I think those are the ones I'm keeping too. Yeah, I'm keeping those because these are handbags that I'm not keeping. But oh my gosh, look at all the hangers. So it's actually the hangers that overwhelm me. Not seeing these piles of clothing, because I've seen piles of clothing before, because like I said, I do this twice a year, but it's just all these hangers now that I have. Okay, and then this jacket needs to go where our jackets are, and these are items that need to be mended. Progress so far, I moved the dresses, the long to the short, the long dresses, from, you know, long sleeve to no sleeves, and then the same with the short dresses, long to no sleeves. Now from dark to light, I don't know if you can see that and see any difference. And then also I did the sweaters, dark to light, long sleeve to short sleeve, and then I moved all the shirts to down here first, because since I access the shirts most often, see, I think it makes a difference. It going from heavy to light. I'm really liking that part. Well, that's all I'm going to show you for today as far as the progress in my master closet, because that's all the progress so far. I will probably finish this up. There are some things that I wanted to do up here. I might get those open drawers that, you know, flip open from the front to store other stuff in that was in here, because I feel like these are not that accessible. And I want, because I don't have drawers, it's something that I need to take a little bit more time in as far as getting those products and arranging and organizing, etc. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, just a progress in applying the KonMari method to my clothing in my master closet, and I will see you in the next
Thanks
video.
For Bye. Watching. LiveLoveLatte.net. You can also find us on Facebook, Twitter, Pinterest, and Instagram.